My email is goodlikeman3@gmail.com. And my P.O. box is 952 Panama City, Florida. If you want to talk, we can talk later after this closes up if you're in no hurry, because I'd like to talk to you some more if you like.
Maybe. I've got to pick up my wife. That truck over there, my wife's out fishing right now.
So oh, okay. Okay.
I'm working with these folks here. I'm on video too, aren't I?
Yeah, I'm going to put you on YouTube because I think you're worth it.
Oh, that's awesome, man.
Can I get you to pose with that card then? Isn't that a beautiful card? Isn't it? How you doing? Oh, yeah. Oh. Is she your better half? Excuse me. You had the long hair. I'm blind in one eye, can't see out the other. I apologize.
Yeah, that's all right.
I'm sorry, okay?
Yeah, I can see
I got him too from working out. I like that. Hey, I'll play you something. After I get done filming, I'll play you something, okay?
Sure.
Hang around.
Okay.
This is Henry Lawrence. Year after year after year, Henry Lawrence has tried to send out a message. He's been at Friday Fest for many, many years. Sorry about the lighting there.
I have been a few shots for Oculus and stuff around town, and I'm actually getting involved with the wildlife every day. I'm going to get their gift shots, so everything's
really
good.
Yeah, I would recommend
Okay.
How do you do that?
I was just reading your bio.
I thought you were from London.
I got a friend who teaches out there now. Tom Bainey.
Yeah, Henry Lawrence. You can't keep a good guy down. Even though he had a very severe life-threatening wreck, he had to have bolts in his head, and he had to be in a halo for many, many months. He did not give up. Henry Lawrence. All right. Yeah, I like that. Yeah. Let me get over here. Yeah. All right.
Yeah.
That's good, yeah. Hey, I got a paper I'd like to give you. These are your rights that Americans are not being told about. You don't mind just taking one, do you? And if you like, after I get done filming, if you want to talk, we can talk.
I'll check you out. I'm going to walk in the jungle real quick. Thank you very much. Got one more song.
Hey, Santa Claus! Can't keep a good man down, huh?
Hey, buddy.
Even after a severe wreck. Now, I want to interview you about that wreck. Tell me exactly what happened, how it affected you.
I don't want to talk about it.
All right, okay. Okay, Henry.
It was 2 years ago, in March.
All I got to say, Henry, man, it was a beautiful...
You get run over, you get a broken neck, you're lucky to live. So.
I believe you, Henry. I believe you.
I survived.
Yeah, what I like about you, how many years have you been doing Friday Fest, and year after year, you never changed your message, you never changed your
tune. Well,
this
is Thursday, this is the 12th year we've done this.
Uh-huh.
And I've been doing Friday Fest, actually longer than that, but I haven't done Friday Fest in the last couple of years, because I got tired of paying them.
I understand what you're saying.
$55.
Well, I understand, Henry, I know exactly what you're saying.
Okay.
I know exactly what you're saying. Did they charge you for this or is this free?
What?
Did they charge you for this booth?
Oh, it costs $400 to use this park, man.
No way, Henry.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
No way.
Oh, yeah.
One person?
The whole park. We had to pay to use the park.
What?
That's why we started charging $10 a booth.
I like your creative art there.
Well, thank you.
I love pastels.
Yeah, that's latex paint.
Huh?
It's latex paint. It's
okay,
but yeah, pastels.
I love pastels. I do. Hmm. Now I can tell you put some time into that.
A little bit.
Yeah. Yeah. That's incredible, man. Would you like a paper? These are your rights and Americans aren't being told. Would you like one?
Sure. Thank you.
My email is jimbikeman3@gmail.com. And also, my P.O. Box is 952 Panama City, Florida.
Mm-hmm.
And what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to waken people up to their rights that they don't even know. Sorry I had to jam everything on one piece of paper because the idea behind it was is for you to be able to copy it one time.
Thank you.
I don't want to take away from your sales, okay?
Oh my God.
So anyway, Bob, how long does it take for you to get that tremolo down to where you can get to that speed that they do of that? What's that song again? Ricardo's what?
Ricardo's
It doesn't, you know, what's difficult about that piece
yeah.
is it's about, what, 6, 7, 8 minutes long.
Right.
And, you know, your fingers start to get pretty tired toward the end of it.
Yes, you're right about that.
So,
I understand the guy was from Cuba, right? The guy that created it, right? He was from Cuba.
No.
He started that style or not?
No. That was written by, I think that's Torrega, Spain.
Oh, okay. Well, anyway, Bob, there's somebody by the name of Gabriela Cuivo. Have you ever heard of her? Gabriela Cuivo? Have you ever heard of Sharon Epstein?
Sharon Epstein, yeah.
What do you think of her playing?
Yeah, she was okay.
So we didn't have another one?
I mean, I don't think she was, like, great. Yeah.
Really?
Really?
I mean, I saw that, and I was in awe.
You're in awe of people being able to play the piece.
Right.
But I mean, if you look at people like Bream.
Julian Bream?
Yeah.
Okay, who else would you recommend that I look at?
Oh, Bream, John Williams.
John Williams, okay.
I would say Bream, Williams, and Segovia are probably up there at the top of the list for most of them.
Yeah.
I don't know. Bream, some of Bream's recordings and some of Segovia's recordings of Bach
right.
are actually wrong.
Really? Because the one called Prelude in D, that's a little piece, but I love it, you know?
Yeah.
Prelude in D.
All right. Well, none of that stuff was written for the guitar.
Yeah, they made it.
No. The D minor prelude. I think which is the one you're thinking
right,
about.
Right.
That was written for keyboard.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
And if you have this, it's repeated.
Right.
Okay, well, on a dual manual harpsichord, you would play the first one here and the other one here because there's a difference. They sound different.
Mm-hmm.
The string is longer on one keyboard than the other. And they use that as what they call an effect or an echo. The second time you play it, it's an echo of the first time.
Oh, I see what you're saying, to give kind of like an echo, hesitant effect.
No, it's not a hesitation. It's just you play the same thing again, but it's an echo coming back. It's not the same sound exactly.
That's like, in other words, if you do the same sound, but you just delay it a little bit, right?
No. You don't delay it. You play it exactly the same tempo, but the first time you play it, the second time you play it, is at a softer volume. That's the echo. Like when you
I see what you're saying.
And I've never seen anybody do that on the guitar that way.
And you've been practicing that?
I'm working on doing it.
Whoa! Well, why don't you put on YouTube, Bob? Put on YouTube your videos, Bob Pasco. Why don't you put them on there? Why not?
Well, for one thing, it would be a lot of work.
Right.
And for what? You know, I'd rather spend that time practicing or being out on the road.
Right. Well, I got here just a little. I guess late's better than never, right, Bob?
Yep.
You push on both of them at the same time. I'll
yeah, I've seen on Beast Drive, I've seen those. I've seen those things on the drains, you know, that saying, you know, not to dump any kind of hazardous stuff, you know.
That's us.
But you're against corporations, so what is your chances of even being able to make a dent?
That's why they have lawsuits.
Yeah, right.
Wait, why do you think God invented lawyers?
Bob, did you say liars? Is my hearing going, Bob? Did you say liars, connivers, thieves? Is that what you said?
All right, what do we pull down first? Bottom or the top?
I don't think it matters.